Hello everyone, my name is Alex with HCI and thank you for tuning in for our product demonstration video. Today I'm going to introduce to you our brand new developed unshielded field termination plug. After our patented shielded field termination plug has been successfully launched into the market in 2018, we receive more and more demands requesting for UTP version. Here you have it. A brand new UTP version features various bending directions. It will surely increase its flexibility when being installed in limited spaces. Before showing you how the plug is assembled, I'd like to spend a few seconds explaining where and when to use the field termination plug. Many of you may have been wondering, a regular modular plug works fine already. Why would I bother using a more sophisticated and probably cost me several times more field termination plug instead? Well, first thing you need to know that conventionally, if you want to install a surveillance camera in a remote space, you need to install both network and AC socket there. The deployment of network socket is relatively easy, but for AC socket, it is not so convenient. Decades ago, someone came up with an idea to use twisted pair cable to transmit both data and low voltage power, now we know as PoE. Here's rule number one. Always use higher category cable with bigger conductors to reduce attenuation and to get a better heat dissipation. However, the problem comes along. Even an experienced installer, one might find it difficult to assemble a modular plug with Cat6A 23 gauge solid conductors. This is where field termination plug comes in. Just like installing a toolless Keystone Jack, you will find it familiar. TIA also regulates this configuration in 2019 and named it as MPTL, which stands for Modular Plug Terminated Link. Also, the other benefit for using a field termination plug is the transmission performance concern. You might have this nightmare before, trying to assemble a Cat6A patch core that complies with Cat6A patch core limit on the field, but can never get it right. Always getting -2 to -3 decibels. You're not to be blamed, because to assemble Cat6A patch core requires skills and techniques that only assembly houses with experiences can manage with high yield rate. With field termination plug, you just do what you have always been doing on toolless Keystone Jack because it features similar assembly process. In the following few minutes, I'll demonstrate how the installation of field termination plug is made. You simply need a cable stripper, wire cutter, and parallel plier. You might be wondering what I'm doing here since I'm with the sales department. Shouldn't it be easier to ask an engineer to demonstrate rather than doing it myself? Well, the whole point here is to show you how convenient the installation is, as well as how easy a Cat6A patch core can be made. If I can do it, anyone should be able to do it too. Let's get started. Firstly, use the cable stripper to remove the cable jacket for approximately 1.5 inches or 40 millimeters. Split each pair. And cut off the filler in the middle. Secondly, push the cable jacket forward against the wall of the wire cap and make sure there is no gap in between. This is very important at the beginning stage because failure to do so, you won't be able to make a strain relief with the cable tie at the final stage. Place green and brown pair first. For performance concern among four pairs, you might want to deal with green pair first due to the inherent disadvantage of the green pair in geometry. I'm not going to deep into that. Just remember, always handle green pair first. Now the green and brown pair are in the right position, followed by positioning the orange and the blue pair. Check from the top, making sure each pair is seated in their designated slots. Now we use the cutter to cut off the excess lens. Here is something you need to pay attention to. Make sure to cut off each wire by turn, not all at once. Do not cut several wires at a time, because there are several plastic ribs getting in the way. You won't be able to cut flush unless each wire at a time. Now we're ready to terminate the plug. Place the wire-loaded cap towards the IDC. You won't be able to put the cap directly from the top. You need to slide in with a small angle. Then the cap can be horizontal. Do you see these two windows on the side of the plug? They are supposed to be inserted by the two ribs on the cap. There is a chamfer around the corner to guide the positioning. Now, this is the parallel plier that I would like to introduce to you as well. It is basically a plumber walk plier, but customized to work with our whole series of products. There are two levels for the purpose of crimping different products. Now place the plug into the second level of the tool opening. Squeeze the handle until you hear the click sound. That means all wires are pierced and connected. We're almost done here. Now you have to determine the routing direction of the cable. If routing straight, just insert the cable tie through the hole and wrap it around. Cut off the excess. Then it's done. If you decide to route the cable outwards, there are two little openings on the wire cap, so you can wrap it around. If you decide to route the cable downwards, find the two openings on the blue part. Remember that the cable tie should be inserted from the left and then out from the right side. Cut off the excess, then it's done. For transmission stability, the cap and the plug is firmly locked once it's been terminated. In case you have to re-terminate the plug because of the wrong wiring, I will show you how to easily remove and take it apart in the following. First, you have to cut off the cable tie. Then use the flat screwdriver, insert it along the chamfer of the plug, slide in, and lever. Once you've done one side, do the same on the other side. Now you'll be able to re-terminate the wires properly again. Now we have come to the testing part. I have pre-terminated the Keystone Jack at the other end. Let's input the standard to TIA and test limit to TIA Cat6A MPPL. Now hit the test button. The happy sound. We have a very fair margin even with such a short cabling, approximately 0.5 feet or 15 centimeters. We all know when it comes to near and crosstalk, shorter distance usually gives worse result. Let's move to patch core testing, I promise at the beginning. Hey, the happy sound again. We also get a pretty good test margin for 0.5 feet or 15 centimeter patch core. If you often make Cat 6A patch core on the field, you'll know a pass doesn't come easy. This is how easy a field termination plug can be installed. It is US patented, easy to use, good performance in any standard specified cabling length, and finally, it's made in Taiwan. I'm Alex with HCI Company. Thank you for watching.